It's March 1st, Mardi Gras, Fat Tuesday, one day before we enter the holy season of Lent. Thanks for joining us today, friends, in prayer. I'm Father Ron. This is the God Minute. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips.
And my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 40, The Lord My Rock. Sacrifice and offering you do not want. You opened my ears. Holocaust and sin offering you do not request.
So I said, "See, I come with an inscribed scroll written upon me. I delight to do your will, my God. Your law is in my inner being."
When I sing of your righteousness in a great assembly, see, I do not restrain my lips, as you, Lord, well know.
I do not conceal your righteousness within my heart. I speak of your loyalty and your salvation. I do not hide your mercy or faithfulness from a great assembly.
Lord, may you not withhold your compassion from me. May your mercy, your faithfulness, continually protect me.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of Peter, chapter 1, verses 15 and 16. As he who called you is holy, be your holy yourselves in every aspect of your conduct. For it is written, "Be holy because I am holy." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Holiness is such an interesting word in our faith. We hear it constantly through the liturgy, paschal mysteries, and the life of the church. Still yet, I think holiness can mean a lot of different things to a lot of different people. Holy to some people can be reserved for the most pious people in our spheres, the people in the church who we believe are on quote-unquote another level from us. Those are the real holy people. In other cases, the really holy people might be the members of the religious communities who have consecrated their life to Jesus. Those are the real holy people. The reality of the situation, though, is that every single one of us is called to holiness because we are all members of the body of Christ. And that alone is a call to be holy and grow closer to the Father. So as members of the body of Christ and partakers in this quest for holiness, how do we conduct ourselves in a way of holiness as St. Peter talks about today? This question is one of the harder questions in our faith because it requires deep reflection on our part, along with a call to action to move towards that holiness. When I think about my own life, I ask myself, what have I done that has allowed me to conduct myself in a holy way? How have I shown the world around me that there is something different about me as a member of that body of Christ? In a lot of ways, I think the answer is by living in a way that Jesus wants us to live. By showing those circles and those groups of people we interact with every single day that they are a beloved daughter and son of God. I had an interesting experience the other day where I was getting ready to get on a Zoom call for work, and I was making my morning coffee. And as I made my coffee, I went to choose a mug, and I had two choices. I had my mug from the God Minute, and I had my work-branded mug. I was actually hesitant to choose the God Minute mug in fear of being judged by my coworkers for being Catholic. However, that's the opposite of the quest for holiness. In the end, I did end up choosing the God Minute mug because at the end of the day, all we really want is if someone is really that curious about my mug, then I would hope they would come to me and ask those questions. While it doesn't get much more mundane than choosing a glass to drink out of, I think it's an excellent example of how we can grow in holiness. It's in these moments of our ordinary lives that we choose God even though we really don't want to. It's in those moments where we show the world our light and love by the way we interact with those in our daily lives. So, my friends, let us walk in that holiness together and make the decision to show Christ to others, even when we don't want to. Because at the end of the day, you never know whose life you can touch simply by having your morning cup of joe.
And with our hearts and minds turned to God,
our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, as I lay down in sleep last night and rose this morning only by your grace, so keep me in a joyful, lively remembrance that all that is good in my life is from you. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before we end, I just want to welcome all our new prayers and listeners here at the God Minute from St. Simon Parish here in St. Louis, Missouri. I just finished a 3-night parish mission and invited them to join our prayer family. So I know many of you have, and welcome in a special way to you. And to all of us this Fat Tuesday, I hope you're enjoying your meat, because there's none tomorrow, your king cakes and whatever else before we kind of settle down and begin our journey with the Lord in Lent. Thank you so much for being with us today in prayer. May God's blessing fill you, hold you, and protect you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We'll see you tomorrow, Ash Wednesday.